It's about 4-something in the morning. We're going to go check out Shelley and Irv.
Since we decided not to use any incandescent bulbs this month, we have to prepare ourselves. Now to prepare some oatmeal and wake up the troops.
Their first alarm just went off. Let's see if they'll actually get up now.
Yeah.
Hey, can I come in?
Yeah.
Time to go to Shelley and Irv's farm.
Woo!
Are you guys ready to go?
Totes.
Ready.
Let's go. We're driving to bed, right?
Yeah.
We're looking for Irv now.
Somewhere at the farmer's market.
It's high drama.
It's too early for this.
We're here on the green roof of Chicago City Hall.
Yes, welcome. 12 stories above street level. Mayor Daley set the goal of making Chicago the greenest, most environmentally friendly city in the country, and if not the galaxy.
All we have to do is find Irv.
Irv?
Yeah.
Is he in here?
Irv, I don't know. Hey, Irv! Irv? Irv?
And the Recognize the Green Roof solve a bunch of the environmental challenges that we face in the city. The first is urban heat island. Cities are hotter than the surrounding areas. A black roof on a day like today is probably 150, 160, even 170 degrees, whereas a green roof is the outdoor temperature. 70 degrees outside, it's 70 degrees in the green roof. And so that really brings the temperature down, makes it easier to air condition inside the building, but it also keeps the ambient environment around the building a little bit cooler.
Irv!
Irv?
If I was a dude named Irv shopping for vegetables, where would I be? Irv! There you are. How are you?
Morning.
So here we are with Irv.
Morning, everybody. Beautiful day in Green City Market here in Chicago. We have a home delivery service for local organic food called Fresh Picks. We serve 60 zip codes in the Chicago area to make it easier for people to get local organic produce.
It also absorbs stormwater. The green roof absorbs that stormwater because it's 80% inorganic material, so it's super light. We absorb that material, hold it for about a 48-hour period, and then slowly let it out. So it reduces that surge to the storm sewer system.
We're picking up 40 bunches of cilantro from Smith's Farm here, which is based in Chicago Heights, right here in Illinois. Because this week, we are putting salsa kits in our mixed boxes as a little treat for our customers. We call our farmers and we tell them what we're going to need. They're already coming here, so we save an extra truck trip, which is, you know, we're all about an environmental mission here. And we're heading to our shop where we have our cooler and where we do our packing.
We've got some beehives up here where we actually harvest honey. Those bees travel a 5-mile radius in and around downtown to harvest the nectar and produce the honey, which is bottled and sold. It's called Rooftop Honey. The proceeds go to support nonprofit arts efforts. We've now developed some incentives. We've got a green permit process, grants. If we're giving somebody money to build in the city, we ask that they install a green roof. So between all of that, we've got about 3.5 million square feet of green roofs that are underway in the city of Chicago.
We pack up our customer orders right in that cooler.
I just found out they usually have music here, but the speakers are broken, you said?
Speaker phones are on, so...
Broccoli goes with my eggplant.
I want you to eat vegetables and eat them all day long. I want you to eat vegetables and make you feel good.
Fresh Picks, you know it's fresh, cause Irv and Shelley picked it themselves. Well, they got it from some farmers who picked it themselves.
And we're fresh.
And they're fresh.
Trying to help existing businesses that are here that are doing green work to succeed. And then also helping to try to attract green businesses to Chicago and try to support initiatives like the Green Exchange.
Green Exchange is going to be the country's first exclusively green business community. The building that you see behind you, it's about a 270,000 square foot factory. It's been around for about 100 years. And we're going to be doing a gold LEED renovation of this building and leasing it exclusively to green businesses to create a synergistic community of businesses that can help each other advance up the sustainability learning curve. It's going to be a great place to be, surrounded by like-minded people that all care about sustainability. Mayor Daley is a big supporter of Green Exchange. He sees this, and the city sees this, as the poster child of the Green Chicago.
Being the Green Exchange, it'll be a great chance to meet a lot of people that are trying to do the same things.
It's a good balance of, you know, sort of incorporating business and the environment and people on the same page.
I spent 1 year traveling around the world seeing these artisans that were in really remote communities. My motivation was to support the artisan craft, and it eventually evolved into purely a sustainable packaging business. My personal agenda is to preserve a craft, to support these people that I think are doing great work, and to support the environment through the kinds of materials that they're using.
Anything that we shred is recycled 100%. The piece of paper goes in a container in their office. We come around in some schedule, pick it up, shred it right there at their location, and then they take it right to the recycler. It gets baled and goes to this paper mill in Wisconsin, and they make all kinds of Cornette tissue products. We shred about 120 tons of paper a month. It's a lot of paper we're saving, a lot of trees. The smallest account is still saving trees.
We take orphaned computers, refurbish them, and provide them to schools, not-for-profits, and in homes of at-risk children. The carbon footprint for a computer is outrageous. In terms of actual manufacturing of it, 1,000 gallons of water to produce one. Reuse is by far the best way to go on this stuff. There's somewhere around like 60 some odd million PCs that are going to be turned off one day, still working, that we could reuse. This is old inkjet printers. The city of Chicago is going to use them in their parking lot.
It's all about working in your backyard. Our efforts have global implications, but really focused on local quality of life.
I hope that we save the planet soon.
It is a triple bottom line project. It's not all about profit. It's about people, profit, and planet. One yurt. It's a people, planet, profit, a triple bottom line currency. We're trying to get a sense for how much this would be worth.
It should be worth a lot because without the air and the planet, we have nothing. That should be worth $1 million.
A million?
Yep. Let's go with that.
I'd say about
$20,000. $20,000?
Yeah. $1 million.
$1 million?
A bazillion.
A bazillion dollars?
Yeah.
We at Yurt are actually going one step beyond. We're looking for the quadruple bottom line.
What's your fourth component?
We're not sure yet. We're trying to figure that out. We got people, profit, planet.
Participation.
Paper-recycle. It starts with a P.
And principles.
Principles.
I just came in with the clothes.
Pride in your community.
I would call it peace.
Fun. P-H-U-N.
Fun.